So you've been using Fooocus for a little while. You get a lot of different styles. You may not even realize you can actually add your own styles to Fooocus. And that's what I'm going to show you here is how to create your own custom styles. I do have a video that explains more about styles in Fooocus, and I do recommend watching that to get a better understanding of how everything works. The first thing to know is the Fooocus V2 is unlike all the other styles, and that's created, that's the prompt expansion, and that's created based upon your prompt and everything when you go to generate. So that's different than the other ones, but it does the similar thing where it adds extra keywords to your prompt. The other ones are all presets, so every time you use those, it'll always add those exact same keywords to your prompt. The easiest way to see that is if we go in here and we go enable into the metadata tab, I do have my images, the metadata embedded. So when I drop it in here, I can see all the prompts that's been added. And if I go into here down at the bottom, we can see we've added these three. Prompt that I typed in was just robots fighting. The V2 prompt expansion added this, and then the styles added these. Now it added these for the negative prompt, this one here, and then this one here, because each one of those styles has their own negative prompts. And the same thing with the full prompt. We'll see that our actual prompt was just that, and everything else was placed in around it. So it's a wrapper, and it wraps your prompt with additional prompt information. So I'm gonna show you how to create those. Now, the first thing you wanna do to do this, and you can do this with just a text editor. You're not going to need any special skills. We want to bring up our primary Fooocus folder. And once you go into there, there's an SDXL styles folder. We go into there, and these are all your different style files. Each one of these includes different styles. You can have them all in one. You can make different files for different types of styles. That's entirely up to you. The easiest way to do this to get started is just to take one of these and make a copy of it. So I'm gonna take the Fooocus one, copy that, paste it. I'm gonna rename it, and I'm just gonna call this one custom_styles. And that's it. I'm gonna go ahead and open that, and you can open this whatever text editor or however you know that you wanna use. We're gonna open this with Notepad++. And looking in here, you'll notice there's an awful lot of stuff in here. We're not gonna use these. We're gonna reuse and delete all these for the most part because we don't need duplicates, we already have them. But if you look at the format, all of these are in the same format. You have your name first of the actual style. We have our comma, and then we have the negative prompt, if there's one. This one's only got the negative prompt. The same with this one. Only has a negative prompt. This one has a positive and a negative prompt. And you can have ones that just have the positive prompt. It's entirely up to you how you want to do this. Most of mine, I tend to just have, well, it depends on what styles I'm using. So let's go ahead and delete most of these because we do not need those. We do want to make sure we get rid of that because the last line, you do not want the comma. If you have multiples of these, you would want a comma between them. You know, follow the format that's originally in the original file. That's why it's easier just to copy and rename one so you don't have to type everything out and then mess something up. So in this one, I'm just gonna change the name. Let's say custom battlefield. So now whenever I want a battlefield image, I don't need to type in all the details of what I want. So in here, I'm gonna leave the cinematic still in here. Then you'll notice this here says prompt. That is the placeholder for where your prompt is gonna go that you type into the box. So we're gonna leave that, and then everything after this, we can go ahead and get rid of. Now in here, I might wanna put, well, what do I want for, well, battlefield. We're gonna do explosions. Smoke, fire, dirty, chaotic. Yeah, I think that'll do. And for our negative prompt, I might not normally need something, but just to show you how it works, we're gonna uplifting and peaceful. Definitely not battlefield things. Okay, so we have everything set up. We have our last one doesn't have the comma. If we wanted to create more, we'd put comma and then we do the same thing again. And you could create a whole bunch in one sheet, one file, or you can have different files depending on category if you wanted to. And we're gonna go ahead and save this. And we got our custom styles in here. And wait a second. It doesn't show up. Well, of course not, because we have to restart Fooocus now to get that to show up. So let's go ahead and shut down Fooocus and we'll restart it. Okay, so if we go in, we have our custom battlefield listed, but as you can see, we do not have a preview. I'm gonna show you how to do that in a moment. That's pretty simple to do. I don't have an image yet. We're gonna have to create one. So let's go ahead and we're gonna do bird's eye view tanks. Now I do want, okay, we got 1024 by 1024. For this one, I'm gonna just change it over to JPEG because that's the format we're gonna want for our sample image. Although you can do it with a PNG and just change the name, that'll work as well. So let's go ahead and generate and test to make sure that the custom style is working. I'm gonna disable these, enable that one, and let's go ahead and generate. Okay, so let's go ahead and stop this. I got what I needed. We can now check to see if this worked. So let's open up our metadata tab. I'm gonna go find one of those images and bring it in. Now, if we look in here, down at the bottom, we did definitely have it enabled. So as we can see up here, it added uplifting and peaceful for negative prompt, which were added from there, so we know that worked properly. And if we look at everything else, it added the prompt bird's eye view tanks, and then it put the rest around it. So everything seems to be working here. Our custom style is all set. And if you wanted to add more, you could add more to this. You could create another one, leave the original ones alone, keep your custom ones in their own files. So now that we have that all set, we know that that is working. We just need to now get our image in there. And that's pretty simple to do. So first we wanna go into our Fooocus folder again. And in there in the styles folder, you'll find the samples folder. So if we go into here, you'll notice all of them are named by the style name with any spaces replaced with underscores. So I'm gonna take that image I just created, I'm gonna drop it in here, and it won't do anything yet. We need to actually rename this. So since our, and we're gonna rename the whole thing because JPEG, with the E in there, it won't recognize that. It's gotta be .jpg for it to recognize it. So we're gonna do custom underscore battle field, which was the name, and then we're gonna do dot JPEG. And we're gonna, yes, we wanna change it. That's all set. And now we shouldn't need to refresh it in Fooocus for it to show up. There it is. So we now have our custom sample image. And you can do that to change any of the other ones that you want. If you'd prefer to have a different image, that's entirely up to you. And that's all there is to creating your custom styles. You can also look online. Other people have styles they share, and you can put those in that folder as well. Do be a little careful if you grab one of the very large files that might have hundreds of styles, because the next thing you know, you may have this list so long that you can't find what you're looking for even with the search function. Hopefully that should get you going with your own custom styles and Fooocus. And if you found the video helpful, please consider hitting the like button or even buying me a cup of electricity. If you want to learn more about Fooocus, do check out some of my other videos. Thanks for watching and have fun creating some of your own custom styles.